The only way you're going to hit those high notes and sustain long wails and have phrases that can, you know, seemingly go on forever is by having the diaphragm of steel. What's up, Metal Sucks fans? This is Brittney Slayes from Canadian power metal band Unleash the Archers, and today I'm going to talk to you about some of my favorite vocal warm-ups, some of my inspirations for our new album Phantoma, and just a couple of pre-show rituals that I like to do, and how I get my voice and my diaphragm in shape for touring and playing shows and all that fun stuff. First thing that I do whenever I'm warming up is a really easy scale on an E vowel, because the E vowel is the easiest to sing, of course. So I just like to kind of start out with triplets up an octave and down again. So it's like E. Do that as high as I can go and as low as I can go. And that's just kind of to get me into the flow of things. The diaphragm is the most important thing about being a singer in a power metal band, about being a singer in general, really, because it's what provides the support and the foundation for everything that you do. So I really focus on having a super bouncy, strong, fit diaphragm whenever I'm getting ready to go on tour. The only way you're going to hit those high notes and sustain long wails and have phrases that can, you know, seemingly go on forever is by having the diaphragm of steel! As I like to call it. One of my favorite warm-ups to do is just up and down the octave on ah. And ah is one of the hardest vowels to do without putting a lot of the control in your mouth. So this one is a diaphragm exercise. And what I like to do is a very slack-jawed ah, so that all of the work is being done with your diaphragm to push the air through your vocal folds in such a way to change the notes. So what it is it's I just make sure, and I'm constantly kind of doing this to remind myself to keep it slack. So it's just ah. And then up. Ah, and you don't ever want to be doing the sound with your mouth. So you want to be going. Ah, you don't want to change the tone or anything with your mouth. You don't want your mouth to do any of the work or your vocal folds. You just want it to, you want the diaphragm to be just pushing the air out. And that's the only thing that's working. And then as I get more warmed up, one of my favorite warm-ups to do is intervals with staccato. So this usually I kind of wait until further into warming up in the night, depending on how far I am into tour. Sometimes, you know, at the beginning of tour, I need like an hour to warm up, and 3 weeks into tour, it's like 20 minutes in and you're ready to go because your voice is just kind of always on point. And so it goes something like this. it'll be 1, 3, 5, 8. 5, 3, 1. And then up. Another one that I like to do is going up and down the scales on all vowels, just to kind of get your mouth and your face warmed up. It's really important, you know, that your lips and your tongue and your jaw and everything are really strong and ready to go. Because again, like I said, you can hold a lot of tone and a lot of pitch with your mouth. So I like to go up the fifth three times and then all the way up to the octave and back down again on A, E, A, O, U. So again, it's hey, ah. And then when you get further into the warming up process and you've kind of done other things and come back and stuff, if you can do that one really fast and actually hit all the notes really clearly, that's kind of the telltale sign. It's like, all right, I'm ready to hit the stage. And then I always like to warm up my soft palate because that's where I put all my wails. So this is a really annoying one. Get ready. So you really want to feel that kind of reverberation in the back of your mouth. You can feel your soft palate kind of vibrating with the nasalness of it. And then that's a good sign. You know, you're warming up your soft palate when that's what you can feel kind of all back in here. So that's how I do that. Yo! That's where that sound is. This album is about a AI that becomes sentient, and she kind of lives in a computer and is watching humans from afar through the metaverse, which is, you know, the future of the internet. And she falls in love with humankind, and she wants to be one of them, and she wants to live among them. So she breaks out of her prison and puts herself into the body of an android and goes to find more of her kind. And the whole album is really inspired by like old school science fiction. It's Star Wars, you know, R2-D2 and C-3PO. It's Alien, it's Aliens, it's Prometheus, it's the whole Alien franchise. I've always thought that Bishop was like such an awesome android character. The way that his character grows throughout the story and ends up being the hero that saves the day, as opposed to in Alien where the synthetic being was the one that betrayed them all. And of course, Star Trek, Data, and his battle within himself. Phantoma has that same battle. You know, she knows who her creator is and she loves them. And then she kind of finds out why she was created, which was for, to be a slave. So, and humankind don't appreciate her and they don't think of her as real, even though she can think and feel. And they reject her when she goes to them to tell them that the collective, which is a group of sentient AI like her, are coming to get humankind and to wipe them off the face of the planet that they have destroyed with climate change. There's also a comic book called Tokyo Ghost, the depiction of the future in that series. It's again, it's climate change has kind of almost destroyed everything. There are pockets that are still livable, but humanity just kind of lives in squalor, and their lives are they have internet all around them. It's kind of like the Apple headset. Everyone just walks through life with these screens on them, and it's very similar to kind of the life that the humans lead in the biomes in Phantoma. Really, Blade Runner, of course. Freaking old and new, huge influences. Just classic. You know, it's been done, AI becoming sentient for sure, but I just wanted to see if I could put my own spin on it and write a story that resonates with people. Phantoma struggles because she's rejected by her own kind and she's rejected by humankind, and she's kind of like, well, who am I and where do I belong? And she ends up discovering that she belongs right where she is and that she's on her own path and no one else's expectations matter but her own. I'm not a thanks so much for hanging out with me today, and I hope some of my vocal warm-ups can help you achieve higher highs and lower lows and longer phrases and whatever it is that you're looking to do out there. Hopefully you enjoyed the new record, and I think it might be out by the time this video comes out, but if not, it's May 10th on Napalm Records, and it's on streaming platforms everywhere. Catch you at the next one. Bye!